axle is broken. That part is broken, and you'll see why very soon. It jerks when you first and drive. We jacked up the car and we put it on those holders. Okay, put it on drive.
Do I keep putting my foot on the brake first?
Yeah.
Okay, so put it on the brake.
Yeah, put it on drive quickly. Okay, when I tell you let go, and then apply the brake slowly when I tell you put your legs on the brake. So don't let go fast, let go slowly.
Okay.
Off the brakes.
But talk loud because I won't hear you.
Don't worry, here, open the other window and you'll hear me now.
Yeah.
Okay. Let go slowly. Yeah, let go, don't worry. Let go. Let go, let go, let go. Okay, keep it. Okay, hit the brake slowly. Okay, good. Turn it off. Yeah, turn it off. So I don't know if you noticed how the axle was jerking as it's moving forward. So let me see if this camera has light. Where is it? Light. Oh yeah, where is it? Okay, cool. So I don't know if you can see it here, even the sleeve is all crumbled. Like there's like ball bearings, like little metallic ball inside here. There's like six of them, and something like got crushed inside here. So when the car's on the ground with the tires on, it'll slip. It won't even spin. The tire won't even slip to spin. Now because it's jacked up in the air and there's not enough force, so it's rotating. But in fact, it's broken. The axle from this part. And we knew we had to change it because when the symptoms of the axle broken is you turn the steering wheel far right or far left, and as you accelerate slowly you'll hear like some knocking noise. So if we turn it, if you turn the steering wheel to the far right, it's the left side axle, and vice versa. So ours, both of them are bad. I mean, you turn it right, you'll hear knocking. You turn it left, you'll hear knocking. And that's primarily because of the nitrous. The oldest people who have nitrous kits in their car, this thing puts so much torque on the axle and anything mechanical, it just wears things out very, very quickly. And plus the car, I mean, it has almost 300,000 kilometers. It's 285,000 kilometers, so, I mean, it's seen better days. We drive a lot, so we've changed the hub or the bearings. The brakes, they're like about 6 months old, so they are new. You can see here, maybe see that the pads are new. Disc is new as well. It's about 6 months old. The axle is about a year and a half old. So it's relatively new, but it's too much torque, like I mentioned, and stuff like that. So these are things to keep in mind. So if you have a nitrous kit, just be prepared to change a lot of parts. Now, we removed the nitrous kit, so we don't have a nitrous kit anymore. We're bringing the car stock back. So one of the things that we need to do is, let me see if I can turn the steering wheel. Turn the steering wheel to the far left. Yeah. Oh boy, turn, don't worry, fast. It's okay, you can let it go. We're gonna have to change this part for the steering wheel, and also this part underneath So these are things also we have to change alongside the axle on both sides. So that will be another video. And now the car doesn't move at all. Okay, we're here. We're gonna change the axle. What you call the CV shaft, you know, or the drive axle. And it's finished on this car. So here's how to do it. Using regular tools that you can buy at the hardware store and doing it the redneck way, and nothing special you need, and I believe, in my opinion, your grandma can do it. It's really simple. So first, we jacked up the car and we put it on stands. If you don't have a stand, or like, never trust a jack to get under a car. That's very important. It will fail. It failed so many times. So use a jack stand like the one I have down there, and I have both of them on both sides. And just as a safety precaution, I mean, if you don't have jack stands, you can put cinder blocks under the car. Jack it up, put cinder blocks, lower the jack, go on the other side, do the same thing. And always, like, I use a precaution, I put the tire, the wheel, under the car. So if, in case the jack stand fails, there's the actual jack, will hold the car. And if that fails, then at least it'll drop on the tire, so it won't go all the way down, you know, it'll crush you to death. Make sure your emergency side brake is on all the way, and put something behind the back tire so the car doesn't roll. In my case, I have cement behind the car, so it's not going anywhere. If you don't have anything to put and you're kind of doing it in a hurry, then I use the spare tire to put it behind the back tire. So let's get started. I remove the wheel. And now, to get to the axle, turn this, like, if you're using this side, turn the wheel that way so you can see behind here. So I'm gonna go turn the wheel right now. Kiswa, can you go turn the wheel? Turn it to the left. And what we're gonna have to do is, we're gonna open this piece right here. Let me see if I can put the light on this camera. Oh yeah. So we're gonna open this piece right here. Yeah. It's just one little screw right here. Sometimes there's a safety pin, you need pliers to pull it out. Don't damage it so you can put it back again. If you can put a new one, it'll be great, but if not, I mean, you can use the same one, I always do. If there is no safety pin, then just open this screw, and once it drops, and you pull that out, then this thing, this entire contraption, can slide all the way to the side, and that is your axle. You need to pull this thing out of that, because we need to change that. That's the axle. That goes all the way down to the transmission, and we need to pull it out. So that's why we're opening this, and the lower ball joint, what they call, is down here. And once you open this one, in my case, there is down here, I mean, sorry for the poor quality, I mean, I'm doing it on the street and it's raining outside and it's shitty and there's not enough light, but I'll do my best. So this is the lower ball joint, and here's my safety pin. There's a safety pin right here, if you can see it, where my finger is at. You need to remove that so you can open this nut, and once this is open, then you need something like a fork to put between here and then lift this up, and then this whole contraption will lift up, and once it lifts, you'll be able to slide it aside and remove this, slide it away from this thing, which is the axle. Of course, before you do all that, you have to open this big nut inside here. That's a 35 millimeter nut for all GM vehicles, I believe, even Japanese, I don't know, but you can ask. So get a 35 millimeter socket, put it in and open it. Now, a lot of people will say, well, I don't have the right equipment and it's really rusted in and it's not gonna move. I'm gonna show you a little trick how to open it really, like, easily. So the trick is, get a wrench that's my 35mm. Well, actually it's 36, it's not even 35, it's a bit bigger, I couldn't find 35. But it'll work in my case. Don't use bigger because you could strip the threads on the nut and then you're fucked. In my case, I know it works because I used it more than once. So this is a little small wrench. No way you can have enough force or strength to open this thing. This is like really rusted in and it's never gonna open. You need like a impact gun, like with air, you know, like the garages to open this. And don't knock it, because if you knock it, you'll damage a lot of things. The way to do it is simple physics. We're gonna extend this arm, so then you'll apply little force and it'll apply huge torque over here. The longer this arm is, the less force you need, the more torque. So to extend it, just get a pipe. I got a little copper water pipe from a hardware store. I mean, get a longer one if you want to have even more torque applied, but to me this is more than sufficient. And what I do is I stand on it, like stand and jump on it. You'll rock the car and it'll open it. But now notice, if I push it, the whole wheel spins. So just have somebody go inside the car and hit the brakes for you. So I'm gonna ask Kisra to hit the brakes, so then the wheel won't spin, so then I can jump on this and open it. Kisra, can you hit the brake? Hit it hard. Okay, so now she hit the brake. See, now this is not moving anywhere. So now I will try to open this. Now I changed the bearing before, so it's loosened. Okay, but in your case, you can just stand on this thing. Me, I'm just gonna use my hand. Probably I'll be able to open it. Let me see if I can position the camera so you can see. Okay, let me see, I'll put it here. Like I said, in my case, I've loosened it before, so it opens up very fast. But in your case, you can just stand on it and jump on that little arm, and you'll hear a pop. That's when the seal is broken here, because it's rusted in, and you'll be able to open it like I'm doing. And once you open this, the axle will be free. If you can push this out, you can push this whole contraption out of the axle, because you need to change that. And the way to push this whole thing out is to open the ball joint at the bottom. And I'm going to show you how to do it. Every car is slightly different, but they all have exactly the same principle. Just look around and you'll see what's holding this thing and open it up. That's all. Now here we are, we opened this nut on this side. So now this thing, nothing is holding it in. This can be pushed out. So now I need to pull this whole thing out to free this from the disc and this hub. So to do that, I'm gonna have to open up this. Let me see if you can see it. Open up right here this safety pin, pull it out, and then unscrew that nut, and then use a fork. Like, this is the tool you can find at like hardware store. Some people use like a little jack. Just be careful so you don't damage the ball joint. I'm replacing it, so I don't care. I'm replacing it right now because it is fucked in my case. Everything is fucked in this car. So the way to do it is you slide this in and then you pry it up, and it'll lift this entire contraption off this ball joint where it's sitting on. Once this lifts, you can push it away, and when you push it away, this thing will slide out of this disc thing, and then you push this all the way on the side and you'll see just the axle on its own. And the axle, nothing really is holding it. You can just yank it out of the transmission. You can pop it in. You can use a like any flat screwdriver or something and gently pry it open. I'll show you how to do that, very, very simple. And then just put in the new one and you're done. So I'm gonna go ahead now and take out the safety pin. Now the safety pin, the way it works is how, I don't know if you can see it here. Now here's the safety pin. You see how this thing is bent? I'm gonna use my pliers and pull this like bend it back so I can pull the pin. It's like a grenade pin. You have like right here, you use the pliers and pull it after you bend the top parts so you can get it out. And then you can open that nut and get it out of the ball joint and stick a fork in here and lift this all up, and you'll be able to get this contraption out of the way. And of course we have to open the top part here, similar, you have one nut here and open it from here. So this and the one at the bottom, both of them has to be open, and we can push this whole thing. So this is the plier I'm using. It's got to be like long and thin like that, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to use it to bend this thing here so I can pull that pin out. It's a safety pin. It's very hard to work holding the camera, but I'll do my best. See how I'm bending it? So then I can just yank this pin from here. So I'm just gonna put the camera down so I can do it properly, and then I'll pull it out and I'll show you how the pin looks like. So here's the safety pin that I pulled out, and I pulled it out of there. So now this nut is free. There's nothing holding it. So now I can just open it with a normal wrench so I can get it out. One thing to note, always lay your parts in a special way so you can put them back in order, because you're gonna have to put everything back the way you took it out. So if you're not familiar with these parts and whatever, just position them in such a way where you can go in reverse and put things back, and then the car will be back. Now, how are we gonna open this screw? Just regular wrench. I mean, spanner, whatever you wanna call this thing. And just put it in and start opening it. And then once you do that, and you open it from here, go to the top one right here. So that's the bottom one, and this is the top one. And it's exactly the same screw, I mean the same nut, the same size. Open that one, and once this is opened, this is generally has no safety pin. Once this is opened, this is the steering wheel column, that's what turns your wheel. This thing pushes out like this, so it turns your tire that way, and then it pulls it back, and it pulls the tire back. So that's for the steering wheel column. Once you open this nut down here, you can just lift this up and it'll separate. So the steering wheel column will separate from this whole contraption. And the bottom, once you open that top nut, you need to put that fork down here and just lift it up. So you can lift this whole thing with the axle and this whole contraption off the lower ball joint. That's where this whole thing's sitting on. And once this is lifted up, first do this, and then once this is lifted up, just push this whole thing out of the way, and it should come off of this thing. So you won't have this will be out of the way, and the only thing left is just this little axle on its own. So that's what we're gonna do. So like just normal tools, and I'm gonna start doing that and show you how it's done. And this is the lower ball joint, and I'm trying like to film and do this, so I'm gonna have to stop the camera, but just to show you like which one I'm opening. after you remove the safety pin, just get a regular simple wrench. You can even use a crescent wrench if you don't have one and you're stuck. You can use like a crescent wrench like this. So anything will get it open, and it's not really tight, and this is not going to be rusted in and tight and everything. So if it is, just spray WD-40 and let it soak for a few minutes. It should come off fairly easily. And after we remove this, what we're going to do is put that fork looking thing and try to lift the whole thing off. And I'm replacing the ball joint too, so everything is fucked in this car. We do a lot of mileage and we drive everywhere and we go off-roading and anywhere fun, basically, we just go. So that's why there's a lot of repairs on this car. And now we're gonna disconnect from the steering wheel. So this is your steering wheel thing, and you have another screw here, and you just simply just open it. You can use a crescent wrench for this as well. So a lot of people ask me, like, we don't have tools, we don't have impact gun or any of that stuff. Well, I don't too. And if you see my videos, I'm using just regular tools with little tricks here and there, and I'm opening all kind of like rusted joints and stuck routers and discs and everything. Just look at these little tricks, and you can do them with regular household tools. Nothing you can't buy from Home Depot or Home Hardware or something like that. I'm also replacing this thing. So this thing, I'm gonna replace it. Now if you replace this and you're gonna see me do it, all you have to do is just unscrew this. After you remove this thing, take this out, pull it out, and then you can twist it open. Now very important, when you twist open, count how many twists you do. So when you put the new one, screw it back exactly the same number, so it comes back exactly the same area, because this is the steering wheel. If you do it wrong, then your steering wheel inside the car will not be straight. It'll be like at an angle, it's gonna look ugly. So this is how you do it. So make sure that how many twists you do to open it, when you put the new one, how many twists you do to put it back. Now I'm gonna do this because I'm replacing this. If you're not replacing this, you don't have to do anything. Just open that, that's all. So then we can push this entire thing away and get the axle or CV shaft, whatever you want to call it, out. Now one thing to note, as you open this, in my case, like it's coming down, there's like a little nut shaped thingy here. You can put a wrench to it and then put another wrench to help you open it, because as you come to some point, see, I have it like all rusted here. As I spin this, the actual screw spin with my nut, so I'm never gonna open it. Let me demonstrate. See, let me push this down so you can see what I mean. So if I push this down, now watch, as I spin my nut, the actual screw spinning with it. So this is never gonna come off. So the way to do it is, they put you another small nut here, like the end of the screw, so you can hold it with a wrench and then unscrew this nut against it. But if it is rusted or and you can't do it anymore, or somehow you put the wrong size and you strip this thing, then the way to do it is just to cut it off. So I'm replacing this whole thing, so I don't care about it. So I'm gonna get my grinder and I'm just gonna cut it off, because it's not coming below, it's not going down below this point, it's all rusted. So I'm just gonna cut it off. Here I'm going to use my grinder, so I'm going to cut that bolt. This thing right here doesn't want to come off of this bolt. It's rusted. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get my grinder and get rid of it. I'm replacing this entire piece, so I don't need it. If you're not replacing it, don't do that. So this is my grinder. Very important, you need safety glasses. And in conjunction, like on top of the safety glasses, you need face shield. If you don't have a face shield, I mean, I don't recommend just safety glasses. It's really dangerous. You get like shrapnels flying at really high speeds and they're incredibly hot. This thing will make a lot of sparks and I mean, it can shred your eyes and it's just not worth it. You don't want to go blind because you're changing the CV axle. I mean, CV shaft, so I'm going to wear my safety glasses and I don't have a face shield, so I'm going to just do the safety glasses here, but I used grinders like so many times and I still have to wear protection. So here we go. Let me see if I can put the camera somewhere so you can see what I'm doing. I'm going to show you what I'm doing. That's the bolt. This is now like really, really hot. So what I'm doing is, here, let me go that way. Hopefully you'll see what I'm doing. See, half of it, I chewed it up. The grinder just chewed it up. I'm going to keep going till the whole thing is cut. And that nut is going to fall down to the ground. So that's what I'm doing. See here, let me push it down. So I'm going to continue doing this. I'm going like really careful and slow because I don't want to hit any other parts like this one or the disc or anything. So you don't want to damage anything, right? So take your time, do it right. And maybe also you need ear protection, like earplugs. So I'm going to continue doing this till this is done. Till it's totally... I did half of it right now, as you can see. I'm going to finish the other half, and then the whole thing will fall. And you can do this only if you are replacing this piece. And this piece is very cheap anyway. This is like, I mean, I would just replace it. It's easier than worrying about getting rusted bolts and nuts and all this stuff. Okay, so here it is. I got it out. That's what's left from the nut. So if you want to see where that was, that was like this. So once we open that, we just lift this by hand, push it aside. Now this is open. What we need to do now is use the fork and lift this entire contraption off the ball joint. So that's your steering wheel column. And once you do that, we will be able to simply move this entire thing out. And this, remove it, and you'll get to the axle. Now, if you recall, this is the ball joint. We need to lift this entire thing off the ball joint because it's sitting on it. So the way to do it is to get like something like this. We call it like a fork, I guess. And find a spot. See, like I jammed it. Find a spot so you can jam it in there, and then use this to lift, push it down, and it'll lift this entire thing up to get it out of the ball joint. So you can put it from either side. For me, this side is easier. You can come on this side as well and try to fit it. So like I have two of them, so I'll use this one from this side to show you. I'm gonna put the light on. So it's very hard to hold the camera and do this, but like you put it like this. You see how? So you take it and shove it like that. And then after you do that, you've got to hammer it in. Like, grab a hammer and knock it in so it can go inside. And then push it down and lift this entire disc array thing off that ball joint. And then it'll be free and we'll be able to take this out and pull it out of the way. Here it is. I put it on this side so you can see. You can see how it's like between. Now a lot of people are gonna find a hard time like pushing this down and lifting this whole thing. Now you have two, I can give you two tricks on how to do it. One, you can extend this arm by getting like a water pipe or something that you can put in it and extend it, and you'll get a lot more torque and you can actually stand on it and jump on it. That's one way to do it. Another way is if you have a second jack, just put a second jack underneath it and just jack it up against this thing and it'll lift this whole contraption. So that's what I'm gonna do. So you don't have to jump on it like a monkey. Now watch as I jack up. Watch how it's going to come off. See? We just got it loose. I don't know if you can see it. So here's from far away. So I got my jack pushing against this thing and this thing lifted it up. Now it's free. I can just move it out of the way. Okay, and we opened it. So we opened the steering wheel one. And we opened the thing, as you can see now. This thing is out of from this hole. So now this whole thing can move freely. Like here, see what I mean by move freely? You can play with it. You can push it out of the way. You can do whatever you want with it. Now it's independent. So that's the ball joint. I'm gonna replace this. In your case, you don't have to, but mine is like really fucked. And I'm gonna show you how to do it. Now, this is the axle. That's what we wanna change. So that's what we wanna get out. Now, all you have to do is turn this straight, give it a couple of knocks here and try to pull this, and the axle should pop in and come out. And then we'll push this out of the way and you'll see just the axle by itself. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Okay, so here, come show this. I wanna see this. You see how now I knocked it out? So now I can just push this out of the way. Disconnect the ABS cables. So I have disconnected the ABS cables. Now I'm going to go ahead and pull the entire disc, caliper, and brake pads away from the axle. Okay, just hold it. So, as you can see, I pushed this entire thing away. And that's the CV axle that we want to change. Now, all you have to do to pull this out is just yank it towards you. You will need to go under the car where it's hooked in the transmission, which will look something similar to this. And let's say this is the transmission. My arm is the transmission. And so that's the axle, and the transmission is like this. So all you need to do is put something in here and just pry it open. It should pop easily. Never put too much pressure. You don't want to break it because there's a ring that holds it in place. So all you have to do, like, just rotate a little bit, pull. Rotate a little bit, pull. Of course, it's not going to come out like this. I have to go underneath and pop it from the transmission end. And that's the transmission end. Like, I'll have to put something in here and then just pry it open, and it should come up like easily without any force, and it's not gonna be rusted there. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that and just pull it out. So there's nothing special to take it out, just pry it open. I'm gonna use this to pry it open. Just put it between the transmission and the axle and just twist a little bit and should pop. If it doesn't, rotate the axle just by a tiny bit and do it again. And if it doesn't work, rotate it and do it again, because there's a ring. I'll show you the ring when I pull it out, and you'll see what I mean. Here you go, I'm under the car. I just pried it open by pushing here against the transmission. You can see the shiny piece of metal. That's because I already opened it up. Now I'm gonna pull it out of the transmission and we'll inspect it. Now, when you pull it, not every car, but some cars, you'll get transmission fluid falling. So keep that in mind. And like, I have an oil pan, I guess. It'll collect the oil so it doesn't fall on the ground. harmful for the environment, etc. So here's the axle, I popped it. There you go. You can see how the transmission fluid is falling. So you'll have to refill it. Transmission fluid is the pink fluid. It's not oil. This is not engine oil, it's transmission oil. So don't confuse it. And don't go pouring it in the wrong place. So let's take the axle out. That's the axle. That part goes in the transmission. And here's the ring that I'm talking about. Let's see if I rotate it. You see where it has a little opening, like a little slit here? So you gotta line that up to pull it out. So now, the most important part is before we put the other axle, you gotta match them. They have to exactly match. Put them beside each other, and those grooves, everything you see here, have to match exactly before you put it in the transmission. So is the other part. Now my axle, you can tell it's fucked. Here it's like all broken. So here's the CV axle, what they call a CV shaft, I guess, or axle. That's the ball joint that we lifted this whole thing off of. This is where the steering wheel column, which is this thing, connects to. And that's it, it's pretty simple. So now the transmission fluid is all draining. And that's where the axle was, inside the transmission. So now, here's the new axle and the old one. And this, like I said, this is the most important part. They don't match. They look like they're identical, but they're not. See, like this part and that one, they're identical. This is a little bit longer though than this, but where it goes in the transmission is totally different. See, my gear ratio here is different than this. In plain English, this is smaller than this. This is like wider, bigger. So, let me see if I can show you what I mean. It's hard to see it in the camera, but I can see it like visually. This thing is a lot smaller than this part. In technical terms, they are different gear ratios. Everything else looks identical, but where it goes in the transmission, it just won't fit. So we have to return it and get the right one. For the Impala SS, whoever have an SS, there's two of them with two different ratios. So best thing to do is take out your old axle and then go there, show it to them and compare it over there, so you don't have to go back. In my case, I have to go back. So I'm gonna put back everything together and go back, get the correct one, and then pop it in the transmission. To put it in is just pop it in till it clicks and reverse all the steps you did. And that's it. You just change the CV axle. So in our case, to be continued. Now I'm going to change the ball joint right here, but I just realized these three screws, they're not screws, they're riveted bolts. I can't remove them. you know, so on both sides they're riveted. So this thing is attached to this entire arm. So I have to change this entire thing. So I got a new piece right here. And that's the ball joint and this entire arm. I'm gonna place it with this one. Now the way to remove this is really, really simple. You have just one screw here. It's one bolt. I already removed the nuts. It's very, very simple. And again, there's another one down there. You gotta remove that. And once you remove these two, this entire arm will fall off. But before you do that, you gotta remove that, the steering wheel column. It's just a small nut here and one at the bottom. Get two crescent wrenches, one at the bottom, one at the top, and just twist them and open this up. And once you remove this, then open these two and let the thing drop. Put the new one in, tighten the both bolts here, and then put the steering wheel column back the same way you took it off. And there you go, you have it. You have it new. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. And once I get that, I'm gonna slide in the new axle. We just got it. The other axle did not fit. This is the new one. This is a good one that fits. So first we'll remove this entire arm, then put the axle back, then slide this thing in and let the axle go inside it, and then take that, lift it up, and put it on the new ball joint and tighten the screw, and then tighten the one for the steering wheel column here. Remember when we took it off? And there you go, put the tire back and we are done. So I'm gonna start and remove this right now. Everything in this car is like garbage. It's all like overused, but we're changing it, so it's gonna be as good as new. So here I opened this one, and this had a piece like that, and this was on top. So what I did is I put a spanner here to hold this bolt to prevent it from spinning while I was opening that one. Once you open that one, just remove it, and then you have one little plastic rubber thing. Take it out, keep it in the same orientation, put it beside the bolt so you can put it back together, and now this thing is free. So all you have to do is drop this arm, drop it, and leave these inside. You can take them off later so you don't mix them up, and this entire arm with the spin will drop free of this steering wheel column, and we'll replace it. Here's the old one. We took it out, and that's the new one. And that's the old one. And it was sitting right here in those two things. So now what we have, this is the disc, the wheel, the disc, the router with the pads. It's like dangling freely from the suspension. So if you want to change your shocks, this is a good time to do that. And also, we have the steering wheel. Those two things there for the steering wheel. Let me turn the light on. Also sitting. And now we're ready to put the new piece. But before we do put the new piece, we still have to take this off. So it's very important not to mix the orientation. So take each one and put it in the ground, one beside each other. So you know how it's very hard to use one hand to do it. But like, remove each rubber washer and put it beside each other. And then what you do is start from the last one and put them back in reverse. Of course, do it on the new piece, not this one, because we're getting rid of that one. That's where the steering wheel column was sitting on, which is this piece right here. When I put it back, you'll see how it looks. So everything is like really, really, really simple to do. I mean, your grandma can do it if you just know which, how to start and like be, get organized. Like I tend to throw things all over the place. Get organized, always put your nuts and washers and bolts in a specific order so you can come back and put them back together. And if you get stuck, always do one side at a time. If you get stuck, just open the other side and compare it. And it's really simple. So, of course, I'm removing this entire thing because the Impala SS have the ball joint, which is just this little piece, not bolted with screws right here. Instead, they're riveted. I can't open them, so I have to replace the whole thing. But 90% of cars out there, all you have to do is just remove these three screws without removing any of this. And then this little piece will come out and put the new one in and put the three screws back again, tighten them up, and you're done. But of course, GM have to make things complicated on top of their shitty parts. So, well, there you have it. It's rusted, it's like all... Well, I guess it's rusted because, I mean, we drove a lot. We went everywhere. So maybe it's not so shitty. So I'm gonna go now and open this, put it on the new piece in reverse order, and then take the entire new piece and fit it in those slots right there and bolt it back again and put the car back together. Hopefully it'll be as good as new. So here I took it off from here and I transferred it to the new piece. There it is. So now this arm is ready to go in. So I'm gonna go in and fit it in and bolt it. Here everything installed, put back together the way we took it off. This is the bar, that's brand new. And don't forget to connect the ABS cables as well. We have changed this part right here, that's also new. Don't forget to put back the safety pin. It should come with the part. Don't put back the old one, just like use the new one that comes with the part. And the ABS, don't forget to connect them again. This is a brand new CV shaft or axle. So this is brand new, been put back again. And it makes sure that it goes in well in the transmission. It'll make a popping sound. Once that ring gets in, it is gonna make like a clicking sound, and you know it's in. And when, don't forget also to top up your transmission fluid and observe for any leaks. Start the car and move it a little and park it, and then the next day when you come in, just go underneath and see if there's any leaks. Even if it's like a few drops, that means it's not put in correctly. Go back, open everything, and make sure it slides in very well. Last thing you need is for dirt and snow and stuff to get in the transmission, and it'll cause you more damage. Pretty much that's it. This is it. It's very simple. I would say, like, on a difficulty level, a grandma can do it. If you just follow the follow the instructions and take your time. Safety first, make sure that when you jack up the car, don't rely only on the jack. Put like jack stands and put bricks or something underneath the car in case if it falls. And on the back tire, make sure you emergency brakes are on, and also make sure you put something on the rear wheel so in case if the car slides back, it'll stop. And I think you'll be good to go. So if you have any questions, message us, and I'll be more than happy to help.